Hello. In this video, I'm going to be talking about AppCacherNG, which is an app caching system for Ubuntu, Debian, and other systems that use the apt package manager. To get started, I'm on a Synology disk station, and I'm in the virtual machine manager, and I've set up a couple virtual machines in here. And if you're not familiar with virtual machines, they're essentially like actual computers, but they run inside of another computer. And I have another video on setting up a virtual machine on this system. I'll put a link below to that. I have four virtual machines here, but we can ignore the top one. The top one is my day-to-day caching system, but for this demonstration, I'm setting one up from scratch. So that's the AppCacherNG server. And then I have client one and client two. So I'll switch over to my terminal here. And the top one is the server, and the bottom two will be the clients. And I'm logged into these servers, and I'll install the AppCacherNG. So I'll start by typing sudo space apt space install space app dash cacher dash ng, and I'll hit enter. I'll type in my password, and then it will install the packages. Okay, so that's installed. Now we want to go to the IP address of this server, and I have it up here in my terminal. You can also type IP space A and see the IP address, so we have it here. And we'll take that and we'll go into a browser and we'll paste that in and go to port 3142, which is the port that the AppCacherNG is running on. So here we have some instructions on setting up AppCacherNG. So I'll pull a terminal up. I'll move this to the side here. So I'll go into one of my clients here. And I want to create a file that looks like this. It's /oo/apt/proxy. So I'll copy that. I'll go into my first client. I'll say sudo nano and then use that path. And I'm going to do that on both servers, on both clients. Okay, so now I have that file open, and I want to paste in this here. And this already has the IP address of the caching system on here. So I'll paste that in both places, and I will save that. So I'll type Control-O, Enter, Control-X, Control-O, Enter, Control-X. And now if we look at this page, if you scroll down a little bit more, it has some other methods on how to connect. I like to use this method. And then under related links, it says statistics report and configuration page. So if you click on that, you'll see statistics on AppCacherNG server. And there's nothing on there because I haven't used it yet. Now that we have this set up, we have the server running on the server. We have the two clients set up. I will type sudo apt update on each of those. Sudo apt update. Okay. And if we go to the server, we can type in tail space dash f space /var/log/appcacherng with the dashes in there. And then let's see, it'd be app dash cacher log. If we type that in, it will show us the log. So this is showing us the caching that it's doing here. If we go to client one, we can say sudo apt install and I'll say node.js. And it will ask us if we want to download these packages, and I'll say yes. So you'll see activity here on the app cacher. And then if we go into the statistics page, we should see some activity. It says, you know, how much data was fetched and how much was served. And then you can click on this here to look at the cache efficiency. You know, I just started this up, so it's not going to have anything. So if we go to the second client now and say sudo apt install node.js and we say yes, then we'll see this on the log file. It's downloading those files from the cache as opposed to downloading them from the internet, since it's the second time we're downloading. So where this could be useful is if you have a lab with, say, you know, 20 or 30 Linux machines that are doing updates on a regular basis. If you put a cache in there, it will pull the most of the updates from the cache, and it'll cut down your bandwidth, and it'll also be faster. So You could also do this if you're testing a lot of things. That's when I've mostly used it. Say you're testing a build of an Ubuntu machine, you screw up, you want to start over. Well, you don't want to have to download all those updates again. You can use the cache, so when you start over, it'll pull those updates locally. If we go back to our page here, we can refresh, and now we can see that the data fetched was 5.7 megabytes, and the data served is 11, because it installed it on two machines. You know, it's essentially cut the bandwidth in half. So if you had a lot of machines, you're going to see this data served go up. That's where you see your efficiency. So that's the basics of installing and using the AppCacher NG. So if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments. If you like this video, please click like. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, I would appreciate it if you could do that. And thanks for watching. Until next time, goodbye.